Hello my dear students, welcome back to the online class today from the same chapter 2 Hydra. This is Roxana Parveen, Senior Lecturer, Department of Biology, Marlison College. Today's topics are structure of a typical neuroblast in Hydra, types of different nematocysts in Hydra, discharging mechanism of the thread or nematocyst in Hydra. The objectives are: if we can understand today's topics, we will be able to draw the diagram of the typical nematocyst or neuroblast in Hydra. Next, we can be able to explain the different types of nematocysts found in Hydra with their specific roles. Number three, we can also explain the importance of neuroblast cell in Hydra in case of locomotion, prey capture or defense, etc. And we will also learn the mechanism of the thread discharge in nematocysts of Hydra of a typical neurocyte. In this portion, we will learn how to draw the structure of the typical neurocyte or neuroblast cell. Okay, and then we will discuss the different parts of the neurocyte and their functions. So, let's get started with the drawing. Get ready with your pen or pencils and your copies. So here you can see I have taken some blank spaces to draw the diagram of neurocyte. At first, let's make a kind of outlines. Okay, so my suggestion is to draw a random sac like this, then the shaft. Okay, then you need to draw the erected thread or the string like this. I am here showing the easiest way to draw the nematocyst. So this is the base form of a nematocyst. So we will put everything regarding nematocyst with the help of the red color here, just to ease yourself to understand, right? And there is the shaft where we should put the operculum. The operculum would be at the side of the string, is, you know, have been erected. That means operculum would be at the side of the string, and just at the opposite side, we will put this sort of structure. This is none other than the cytoplasmic structure. Okay, and here we may put the sting or any kind of spine like structure, which is called nidocil. Just you can match at your book that how, you know, nidocil helps to trigger up to erase this thread. Okay, so here we need to show bit of things. Here I'm showing this, you know, this dot 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 places just to make sure that this is the cytoplasm, and you know that cytoplasm contains large nucleus. Okay, this is the nucleus at one side, and I am putting the green color over there to show the lasso. Okay, and some other structures too here. These are the myelin fibers, which acts like the muscle fibers. Okay, I guess that's it. And here you see these poisons are called hypnotoxins. So let's get started with the leveling. So at which side it's convenient to level? However, let's make a kind of outline over there. Okay, why we need this outline? To make sure to just level all the things. Okay, to level all the things within a level. Clear? So here let's move on from the central portion, that is nematocyst or nematocyst sac. okay, and this one is the barb, okay. So let's level the barb, but one by one we need to make it centralized. Then this one is the cytoplasm, okay. So this one is nearer, so this one is the operculum, okay. Next leveling would come to the barbs. So as it's written in, to make it easier, this one is the barb, okay. There are three barbs, so you see here. Then you can see the small barb-like structures, which are called barbules or tiny spines, okay. And the whole barbs and barbules are taken by the butt or shaft, clear. And let's come to the cytoplasmic portion. These are the, you know, living portion. This one is the cytoplasm, you see, and this one, these are the muscular structure called myonym fibers or muscle fibers, and this one is the nucleus, okay. And this portion is called the lasso, okay. So as you can see the overall picture here, and this is the string, and the whole sac is filled with hypnotoxin, right? And we didn't mark this. We can make it in different side or this side too. Here you see, this one is called the nidocil. Okay, nidocil, this portion is called the nidocil. So you must mention all these necessary things to draw the diagram, and never forget to name the diagram as figure, cross section of a nidoblast or nidocyte, okay. And finally, we are not done yet. We have done a huge mistake just leaving this straight line over there. We need to rub this. Why we should rub this? We should not just keep it out there after finishing the labeling, because this doesn't stand any meaning, clear. So let's review and let's try at your home. And always remember that you cannot touch pen out there. You have to use pencil to level all these things. Make sure no diagram could cross each other. So here is the another concept. The most of the students make mistake like this. Suppose I am gonna level this one. Suppose I'm thinking that there is no space. So what should I do? I can just get directly out there, or I can just cross like this. Yeah, I can, but it doesn't mean anything. Clear? We cannot hurt any figure or any portion by crossing. Clear? So let's practice. There are four types of nematocysts found in Hydra or overall cnidarians, starting from the stenotyl or penetrant. Next is the volvant, next streptoline glutinant and stereoline glutinant. So you see the structure of the stenotyl or penetrant nematocyst, which is formed of, you know, hypnotoxins inside the sac, and there is a kind of traces of small barbules along with the bars on the shaft. The penetrant has another significant roles of the, you know, food capturing or other activities like having shelters and so on. Number two is ball vent. As you can see, the ball vent nematocyst is formed of twisted strings. So these help to hold any substratum or any shelter while moving from one place to another. Third is the streptolyne glutinant. You see, the streptolyne glutinant is all about the gluey substances or secretion of the glandular or sticky substances. This sac is filled with different sorts of sticky substances which are, you know, secreted over anything when they do locomote. Okay, as you can review at your syllabus that during locomotion for looping and somersaulting, we need to mention the names of streptolyne glutinant and stereolyne glutinant. So these sort of nematocysts help in locomotion mainly. It has other roles too. So you need to practice a lot on the types of nematocysts and their functions. The third one is the streptolyne glutinant. This one is also known as hollow tritias isorhiza. They are of intermediate size. The thread is long, open-ended, and got a row of small barbules. It facilitates locomotion, predation, and adhesion. The fourth one is the stereolyne glutinant. The another name is Erichus isorhiza. This is the smallest type of nematocyst without barb and barbules. It contains a short thread with a free end. Clear? It facilitates also the same like the streptolyne glutinant in locomotion, predation, and adhesion. Okay, let's know something about the discharging mechanism of nematocyst or how the nematocyst thread is discharged from its capsule. So this is a very easy process, but we need to explain a bit with some points like the discharge of nematocyst takes place when nidocyl is stimulated by food, prey, or enemy. Neither touch alone nor presence of food causes the discharge, but touch and pressure of food together cause its discharge. The wall of nematocyst is impermeable to water, but on stimulation, the capsule wall suddenly increases its permeability, which causes a rapid intake of water and osmotic pressure increases inside the capsule. As you can see here, the osmotic pressure is increased over there due to endosmosis of water. As a result, the upper coulomb or the lid opens up, it forced to open. The coiled thread tube turns inside out and the entire nematocyst explodes to the outside part. Okay, so Hydra captures the prey by throwing out a coil of thread around it, paralyzing it by hypnotoxin present in the sac and wounding it by the barbs of the thread that penetrate the skin of the prey. Once a nematocyst has been shot, it cannot be regained. The nidoblast is regained with the help of interstitial cells. As you can see, when they capture the prey or something like that, they inject hypnotoxin in the prey's body, the depleted cells cannot be recovered unless interstitial cells work on this. As you can see clearly in the diagram how the sac is pressurized and how the twisted thread gets out of its sac. As you see, when it just accumulated inside this sac or inside the nematocyst sac, okay, after the stimulation with the help of the nidocyl here acts as the trigger over there. So then the hinged operculum opens up and the thread gets out of the shaft gradually. Okay, and finally you can see that through this, you know, string or the string here, the, you know, the poisonous substances are getting out of the body. Well, I'm about to finish the class today. Today's homeworks are: explain the structure of a nidocyte of Hydra. It must be the typical one or the normal one I have discussed. Number two, draw and level the microscopic view of a typical nidocyte in Hydra. Here you must follow the rules and regulations of drawing, leveling, and putting the figure's name, all the things in pencil, obviously. Number three, explain the types and roles of nematocyst in Hydra. And finally, explain the mechanisms of thread discharge in Hydra. In case of the fourth question, you must follow the, you know, sequences of mechanism. And for number three, while explaining the roles and types of different nematocysts in Hydra, it's suggested to put the separate types of nematocysts along with their importance. For example, you are explaining the penetrant nematocyst, right? So here you must explain the defense and food capturing roles for this sort of nematocyst. It's a great service, right? And finally, you can add some sort of glutinin nematocyst in case of locomotion. You have already seen that during locomotion, we've discussed the names of the glutinin nematocyst to capture or to hold on the substratum. So that's all for today, my dear students. If you have any problems regarding today's lecture, put your problems or the issues in the comment of this video, or you can just post it to the homework group. Thank you very much.